Let's first see who's here. Who's a dev, a developer? Okay, thank you. Who is an ops guy? Okay, who's an ops guy, not a dev guy? Okay, very good. Because if there's only ops people here, then the discussion is a bit one-sided. Okay, the fishbowl is simple. There are four chairs. One chair remains empty. On the other three chairs, people sit and discuss the topic. And only the people sitting on a chair are allowed to talk. If you want to participate, you stand up and sit on the free chair. But then one of the other three people has to stand up and produce a fresh free chair so that we always have a free slot available for the next participant in the discussion. And the people hiding there behind, they're also invited to come forward and participate. So I was actually very happy to get some feedback on Meetup about this question. And this is a question I'm actually very passionate about, because in my impression, this is what happens a lot. It's like devs throwing balls over the fence and ops trying to catch them. And luckily, in many cases, this is part of the enterprise IT, which many of you and us already left behind. But you know, there's always more to go. And this who has root access is, in my opinion, one of the last bastions of ops. It's like the last thing that ops will hold onto like a holy grail. And I would like to challenge that, because actually, this is not DevOps. Hey, Cetrix. This is DevOps. All holding hands, doing stuff together, being friends. And if you think about that a little bit and go back to that initial question, why give devs access to root in production, I actually think that question is completely wrong. And nowadays, we shouldn't be discussing the question why to give devs root access, but why not? What's the reason for not giving devs root access? And if you can't find a really good argument for that, then you're lost. Then you apparently have to give everybody root access. And I claim that we should be giving root access, not based on who you are, but on the question, do we trust you to really act in ours altogether common interest? Do you have the commitment to fix anything that you will be breaking? Do you have the commitment to fix stuff that your colleagues broke and ran off? And do you have the skills to really carefully treat while navigating our very complicated data center so that you don't take down stuff with your butt while you turn and, you know, like the elephant and the porcelain shop? That's the question, and I claim that if you get to these questions, then the question if you're a dev or an ops or a manager or a QA guy or the janitor, and if you need to get root access, is completely independent. Thank you.